here it comes! From the fabulous penthouse studios of News Talk 1070 KMTH, this is The Price is Right! This is The Price of Business. Author of the hugely influential Empowerment to the People, award-winning, nationally syndicated columnist, Kevin Price brings a fresh perspective to business news and the events that shape our lives. And now, here is the star of The Price of Business, Kevin Price.
Good evening. I am Kevin Price. I'm delighted to be with you here today to be able to talk to you about you and your business. And let me tell you, we have a lot to talk about. Not only are we going to talk about some things that are happening on the national political front, enormous push going up against Barack Obama's tax proposals. Later on in the program, we're going to talk a little bit about what's happening in business, and that should be interesting as well. But this first segment, I've got Heather Piedmont Bachman on the program. And Heather, how do we go? How do we describe you on an ongoing basis besides Heather? I'm assuming that you're Heather Bachman.
Yes. Yes. Well, my maiden name is Heather Bachman. My married name is Heather Piedmont. Okay. I'm known as Heather Bachman politically, so that's why I put Bachman.
Got it. There we go. And that's exactly what we're going to talk about is politics. And you've got an interesting background. Did both undergraduate and legal studies at Regents University, and also been involved in media and the development of your own media program. What are we going to talk about here on tonight's program?
Well, what I'd like to talk about a little bit is the price we are paying, since this is the price we are paying with ignoring the right people when it comes to politics, i.e. the youth and the activists that actually want to spend the time and their own money to actually create some objectives and some results in this national governmental system. What I mean is, if you watch any of the Sunday morning programs, or even Sean Hannity or Limbaugh, they touch a little bit on youth issues, but they don't divulge into it. And as a result, we're paying a price of actually alienating the people that we're going to need, not only for 2012, but also beyond. And when I talk about political activists, we listen to the wrong people when it comes to these quote-unquote political icons, when we should be listening to the people that are cashing in their IRAs to go to Tea Party rallies, to create petitions, and to create some actual movement for the best of this nation, mm-hmm. instead of just for the best of their pocket.
So let me talk a little bit about this. You know, one of the things, there's an old cliche, if you're under 25 and conservative, you have no heart, and you're older, over 25 and liberal, you have no brains. I think there's this kind of belief among those on the right that young people are not going to vote conservative. And right now, you've got a huge amount of an electrifying response taking place when it comes to Ron Paul. This, you know, 70-something-year-old man has generated a lot of interest, but he's quirky. He's not a traditional conservative by any stretch. He's far more libertarian than he is conservative. I mean, right. Is this? Do you think there may be a belief on conservatives in the media? And I'm one of those, but you know, you seem to be watching this particular area closer than others. That right. They have written off young people.
Absolutely. The conservative people have definitely attempted and have succeeded in writing off people. And I don't believe it's the Ron Paulites that we should be looking at as an example. We should be looking at the youth that are calling into programs such as yourself and asking, why are you doing this to my future and I'm not allowed to say anything about it? You have to realize something here. I remember watching a Tea Party rally, and there was a six-month-old with a poster over her carriage, and it said, "I'm already in debt thanks to you. Why can't I have a say?" And that's the bottom line. We're not able to have a say, and we're going to be the ones paying the price in the long run. It's not going to be the senior citizens, and it's not even going to be the adults of this year. It's going to be the young adults, the people that are coming out with graduate degrees such as myself and are now looking for jobs at Burger King mm-hmm. because of this recession continuing. The ones that are graduating with law degrees and having no possibility of even creating their own law firm because of this recession. Mm-hmm. We're the ones that are being affected, and we're the ones that are not allowed have a say. And the biggest culprit, I think, of this is these high priced fundraisers. I'm on every conservative Republican candidate or what have you newsletter, and I keep seeing $1,000 plate dinners, and I understand that needs to be done, but there also needs to be $10, $20, and $30 plate plate events for young people to be able to be interactive in this. Mm-hmm. And also we have to find some aspects of financial to assist them in order to be able to participate in the public sector. That's one of the reasons why you don't see a lot of young candidates anymore, because we can't afford it. Yeah. And that's the biggest thing right now.
I think that's an interesting take, but I think there's so many more other issues that are involved when it comes to young people. When it comes to, I mean, again, there's this kind of knee-jerk reaction when it comes to young people that they are going to be more and more liberal, and so it's difficult for those on our side. And I agree with you entirely. I mean, forget about you know, 6-month-olds. We're talking about great-great-great-grandchildren of ours who are going to be saddled with this debt. It's unbelievable.
Absolutely.
What has taken place, and it is theft, and it's legal theft, and it's one of the great weaknesses of a democratic form of government, that we can literally vote away the financial futures of those who aren't even here to vote. Is unbelievable. But fundamentally, young people, you know, and of course they don't get this except for over time. They've got to be a group that becomes more approachable. Are you saying that you think if they were reached more directly, that they would potentially be the conservative message would resonate more with them?
Absolutely, especially these days with our college graduates graduating with student debt and not being able to find even a minimum wage job. I'll give you a great example. Myself, I have 2 master's degrees. I'm a former White House intern, and I've got a radio and television concept that would reach out to the youth directly. But the only problem is all the networks want to turn their backs, and they turn their backs and they say, oh, we already got this kind of program. No, you don't. If you had this kind of program, there wouldn't be a need for youth outreach. Last political cycle, if you walked into a McCain rally, you were told to turn off your cell phone. If you walked into an Obama rally, your cell phone got a welcome message, an ability to donate $5, and a connection with the Obama campaign just for having your cell phone in the same building. We are reaching out more in social media, but we're not reaching out to them to create impact for them and by them. That's the bottom line.
Heather, I got to wrap it up, but I really enjoyed it. And I tell you, people need to check out her message over at Heather Bachman, that's BACHMAN, heatherbachman.com. Check it out. Learn more about what she's talking about. As you can tell, she's really passionate. Our side does generally ignore young people. We haven't seen the electrifying, electrified youth, if you will, when it comes to conservatism since Ronald Reagan, and that's when I was in students for Reagan in 1980. And so maybe she's got a message here. People need to check it out. Thanks for being with us, Heather.
Thank you.
You bet. All right, when we come back, much, much more for you right here on The Price of Business.
We want you to know that the old methods to get new clients do not work. According to recent studies, business owners are spending more time than ever building their businesses, and they have less interest than ever when it comes to dealing with salespeople. So how do you get their attention in this tough economy? A new free report details a program used to profoundly open doors. It's been used on CEOs of Fortune 500 companies, famous entrepreneurs, and even national government leaders. Simply send an email to info@usdailyreview.com.